I am an alumnus of Semmelweis University. The university gave me formative influence on how to become a doctor and how to become a researcher. I really think Semmelweis has given the right proportion of theoretical knowledge, which is very helpful in your life as a scientist, and the practical clinical skills, information and knowledge, which is very, very useful, not only in clinical practice, but in practical research. And at least a dozen, if not more, of my closest family, including my mother, wife, daughter, cousins, nephews, nieces, are Semmelweis alumni. Semmelweis is a part of my own life and the family life. And to become an awardee of my old university, Semmelweis University, means a lot for me. So if you would like to solve an issue, let it be, in my case, a psychiatric or neurological question, a situation, then you have to make a choice. If I am a practicing doctor and I can see, say, 10 patients a day and cure maybe 8 of them, it's a great success, brilliant. But if there is a question which I can solve, and with the solution I can help maybe 10,000, maybe 100,000 patients, it's a great motivation. My message is very simple. Never give up. Please try to focus on a major goal and go through the way which you have chosen. Don't turn left or right. The way will be a meandering. You never go from A to B alongside a straight line. You will always find something interesting here and there, but hopefully sooner or later you will reach your goal. And if you would like to become a researcher, you have to learn 3 major things. You have to be a novelty seeker. You have to find always new things. And novelty seeking is one of the major traits of a researcher. Number 2, you have to be a challenge seeker. You will find challenges all the time, everywhere. And you really have to be a challenge seeker personality. Either you have to learn it or you inherited it in your genes, but challenge seeking is one major trait. And number 3, you have to be failure tolerant. Failure tolerance is the 3rd major trait if you would like to become a researcher. And one important message: if you have a failure in your life, always use it as a lesson. Learn from this lesson in order to go to the next level. Failure should never discourage you. To the contrary, a failure should encourage you to learn from it and go to the next level.